In this video, we'll explore how to read and understand your reports in MaxiFi Planner. As a new user, this video will give you a bird's eye view of the key reports that help you make sense of your plan. Let's start by running a base plan report. Now, once that is done, you're going to land on a dashboard that gives you a nice overview of everything. You'll see your lifetime budget, a discretionary spending plan, a retirement account saving withdrawal plan, and a regular asset saving withdrawal plan, among a few others. Now, each section gives you a quick explanation and introduces some of the key terms that you'll see throughout the report. On the far right is a menu tree where you can access more detailed reports. You'll see the spending, income overview, saving reports, and other reports. Notice how reports like the spending overview include sub-reports as well. The spending overview includes a sub-report per adult living standard, taxes, and federal tax detail. For now, we're going to focus just on a few of the most important reports. Here we are looking at the spending overview. This is where you'll find your annual discretionary spending, a very important number in your plan. In this case, the family has nearly $104,000 per year of annual spending allowance. This is a number that's calculated internally and can be used as a reliable benchmark when comparing different plan scenarios. If you look at the far right at the total spending column, you can work backwards by subtracting each fixed expense across the row until you reach discretionary spending on the far left. This makes it easy to see that discretionary spending plus fixed spending equals total spending. Now, for further detail on fixed spending items, such as housing, visit the detailed report Housing and Real Estate. You'll see that a housing expense of $5,700 breaks down to $4,000 in property tax and $1,700 in home insurance. Now, how is this family able to afford this level of spending throughout their lifetime? Well, the answer lies in the income overview and the savings reports. The savings report includes your regular asset saving plan and your retirement account savings plan. The regular asset savings plan gives you a bird's eye view of your accounting, showing your total income, total spending, and how much you're saving or withdrawing from your regular assets. In years when your total income is higher than your total spending, MaxiFi will suggest saving the excess, as we see here in the year 2025. In years when your total income falls short of total spending, it recommends a withdrawal to fill the gap. In 2027, MaxiFi suggests withdrawing $35,757 from regular assets to maintain their spending. The math always balances total income minus total spending plus or minus savings or withdrawals equals $0. It's this pattern of your savings and withdrawals that keeps your discretionary spending smooth and sustainable. This spending path is unique to your model and will change as you update your assumptions or other inputs and rerun the base plan. I also want to point out, in years when there is savings, the saving amount does not come out of discretionary spending. It's actually excess. Now, if you're wondering, what makes up total income? Say, what's included in the $247,474 of total income for the year 2025? Well, you can find the full breakdown in the income overview report. The income overview summarizes non-asset income, retirement account withdrawals, and regular asset income. And if you want to see more detail on what makes up total spending, well, that's where you can visit the spending overview report that we looked at earlier. Now, the other plan in the savings plan is the retirement account savings plan. In the retirement account savings plan, you'll see retirement account contributions, as well as the timing and dollar amount of retirement account withdrawals according to your data and settings. Here is where you'll view required minimum distributions, or RMDs, if applicable, any Roth conversions, and any special withdrawals you entered as well. These three reports, spending overview, income overview, and savings plan, can tell you a great deal about your base plan. A final report worth mentioning is the year at a glance report. The year at a glance report is your all-in-one summary. Just select a year at the top, and you'll see your total income, fixed spending, discretionary spending, and more all in one place. Click any number to expand it, and it will open like a full balance sheet for that year. Notice that everything will always balance to zero. To recap how to read your base plan report, start with your spending overview to get a clear picture of your annual discretionary spending. From there, explore your income and your savings plan to fill in the details. Your plan will change over time. Update your inputs and rerun reports as your situation evolves. If you need additional help, click the green help button at the bottom right of any screen to open support. You can search step-by-step guides and frequently asked questions, view suggested articles based on where you are, or contact customer support. Thank you for watching.